Aimee Anne Duffy, born June 23, 1984, is a Welsh singer, songwriter and actress. Born in Bangor, Wales, she was introduced to Jeanette Lee of Rough Trade Records, which led to her signing a recording contract with A&M Records in 2007. Following the release of the singles Rock Fairy, 2007, and Mercy, 2008, the latter reaching singles charts worldwide, Duffy released her debut album Rock Fairy in 2008. The album entered the UK album chart at number 1, and became the best-selling album in the United Kingdom that year, with 1.68 million copies sold. The album was certified several times platinum and sold over 7 million copies worldwide, spawning further successful singles. With Mercy, Duffy became the first Welsh woman to achieve number 1 on the UK singles chart since 1983, while Rock Fairy was awarded the Grammy Award for Best Pop Vocal Album amongst further nominations at the 51st Grammy Awards. In 2009, she won 3 Brit Awards for British Breakthrough, Best British Female, and Best British Album. In 2010, Duffy released her second album Endlessly. Following its relative critical and commercial failure, in February 2011, Duffy announced she would take an extended hiatus from music before beginning work on her third album, and made her acting debut in the film Patagonia. She has since appeared in and contributed music to the film Legend, 2015, playing American singer Cheshire-born Mark Durston for over 5 years until November 2006. Duffy lived in Abersock with him. In September 2008, Duffy mentioned that she was on the borderline of a nervous breakdown because of the pressure that fame has brought her. She said that she had considered becoming a recluse, but eventually decided against the idea for the sake of her fans. Although acknowledging that most people do mean well, she finds it scary when people recognize her in the street, and has been fearful of her image possibly changing the person she truly is. Duffy's estimated fortune of £4 million placed her in 16th place in the 2009 Sunday Times listing of Great Britain's wealthiest young musicians. On October 3, 2012, Duffy escaped from a fire in the rented penthouse apartment in which she was living, Abbott's House in Kensington, London. At the 51st Grammy Awards held in February 2009, Duffy won a Grammy Award in the category of Best Pop Vocal Album for Rock Fairy. Earlier she had been nominated for awards in the categories of Best New Artist and Best Female Pop Vocal Performance for her single Mercy. Duffy equaled Coldplay with 4 2009 Brit Awards nominations. She eventually won 3 awards, including Best Album for Rock Fairy, one behind the record held by Blur for the most won in one night. I cannot tell you what this means after 5 years of hard work, Duffy said. 76, at the awards ceremony she performed Warwick Avenue. Record producers and songwriters Steve Booker and Bernard Butler gained awards for their work on the Rock Fairy album. She shared a 2009 Ivor Novello Award in the category Most Performed Work with Steve Booker for their work on Mercy. Songwriter E.G. White won the award for Songwriter of the Year in part for Warwick Avenue, which he co-wrote with Duffy. Mercy was played on United States radio and television more than 3 million times, earning Duffy a 2009 Broadcast Music Incorporated award. The album was nominated and shortlisted for the Album of 30 Years category at the 2010 Brit Award. Following success on Wah Factor, Duffy recorded a 3-song Welsh extended play, titled Aimee Duffy, while working part-time in 2 jobs as waitress and in a fishmonger's. It later achieved Welsh chart success in 2008, charting at number 1 on the SIART C2 music chart. Duffy, now in high demand, appeared on Mint Royale's See You in the Morning as a backup singer. Duffy was introduced to Jeanette Lee of Rough Trade Records in August 2004. After singing Richard J. Parfitt's Oh Boy. Lee moved Duffy to Crouch End in London, orchestrating a meeting between Duffy and Suede's ex-guitar player Bernard Butler. Lee, with Rough Trade, would eventually manage Duffy. After Butler had given Duffy a soul music education by downloading tracks onto her iPod that she could listen to while around London or traveling back to Wales, the pair co-wrote with her and helped create a new retro sound. The music included tracks by Al Green, Betty Swan, Ann Peebles, Doris Duke, Scott Walker, Phil Spector, and Burt Bacharach. Duffy was quoted as saying, "Betty Swan is one of my biggest inspirations, particularly her song Cover Me, because it marks the time I got interested in physical contact. I was 19, and here was a woman singing Cover Me, spread your precious love all over me. It's very tender, but it's also, hilariously, quite crude." Duffy singing at SXSW, March 15, 2008. Duffy was contracted to A&M Records on November 23, 2007. She performed on the BBC Two television show later with Jules Holland, which resulted in a second appearance on the related broadcast Hootenanny, where Duffy performed with Eddie Floyd. On February 22, 2008, she appeared on Later with Jules Holland for a third time and performed Rock Fairy, Mercy, and Stepping Stone. Duffy also made appearances on the BBC Two television program The Culture Show on February 23, 2008, performing Mercy. In January 2008, Duffy came second to Adele in the annual BBC News Online poll of industry experts Sound of 2008, for acts to emerge in the coming year. In Wales, following Duffy's recent promotion of her music, Aimee Duffy reached number one on the Syort music chart. By 2007, Duffy was finalizing her debut album effort, to be titled Rock Fairy, after Rock Fairy, Where Her Grandmother Lives. She subsequently struck a U.S. label deal with Mercury Records, a newly reactivated imprint of Island Def Jam Music Group. The first single from the album, also titled Rock Fairy, was critically well received, with Allmusic calling it a grand sweeping ballad. Born in Nefyn, Gwynedd, to an English father of Irish ancestry, John Duffy, who was born in Liverpool and brought up in Rock Fairy, Wirral, and mother, Joyce, born in Gwynedd, Caernarfonshire, and brought up in Nefyn, near Pwllheli. She was partly raised in Nefyn with her twin sister, Kate, and older sister Kellyanne, who was born in 1980. Duffy's parents divorced when she was 10 and she moved to Letterston, near the Pembrokeshire town of Fishguard, with her mother and sisters. Duffy attended Scoil Nefyn, Nefyn School, Gwynedd on the Lynn Peninsula, and Sir Thomas Picton School in Haverford West, Pembrokeshire as a child. At the age of 17, she attended the Pwllheli campus of Coleg Mirian Wyfer to study for A-levels. She subsequently went to the University of Chester and studied commercial music production on the Warrington campus. From 2004, she studied performing arts at the Parkgate campus. In September 1998, at the age of 14, Duffy was briefly put in a police safe house when authorities uncovered a plot by her stepfather's ex-wife to pay an assassin £3,000 to kill her stepfather, Philip Smith. Smith's ex-wife, Dawn Watson, was sentenced to a 3.5-year jail term for soliciting to murder. "I was so terrified. I felt so ill," Duffy recounted in 2008, as reported by The Enemy and The Sun. Duffy describes living in the safe house as a dog-eat-dog, claustrophobic and isolating experience. Aged 15, she ran away back to her father's home in Nefyn. Duffy said in retrospect, "It was a horrendous thing to do." Her mother and her sisters did not speak to her for about a year afterward. In reaction to her parents' breakup, her next 3 years were a rebellious period that included binge drinking and stealing the rowing boat. Duffy performing at the SOS 4.8 Festival in Mersa, 2009. After finishing her GCSEs in Pembrokeshire, Duffy returned to Nefyn, to live with her father, when she was 15, and started singing in various local bands. Duffy then spent 6 weeks in Switzerland, before she started college, collaborating with the writer-producer Soren Monier, under the name Slgo. She was advised by a lecturer at Chester University to go on Adele, Love, and become a singer. She also built up a following at Alexander's, a local jazz and blues club in Chester, performing with guitarist David Burton from the band The Invisible Wires. Duffy returned to Wales in 2003 and was invited to appear on Wow Factor, a Welsh television talent show. She was expected to win but came second to winner Lisa Bedrick.